Hello, everyone. My name is Veronique, and I'm gonna teach you today your first live workshop painting acrylic class, and I really hope that you're gonna like it. I was a teacher for a long, long time, and I was a college professor before in art and design, and all of my life, I was always teaching professionally, and I really, really love to teach, and I love the interaction with all of you guys. So I'm really glad to be here today, and this is gonna be the first virtual painting workshop, but I'm gonna do one at least once a month, and it's always gonna be free, and because I wanna share everything that I have learned through the years. So sometimes it's gonna be really a painting workshop like the one that we're doing today, but sometimes it's gonna be more about a business point of view or graphic design or marketing and stuff like that. So I'm gonna share a lot of different things. And you see over here, it's my setup. And I hope that you're gonna have a good view of everything that I'm gonna do. If you have any question, you can see that there is a chat, and I did already put some information for you guys, but also you can ask me questions or comments, and I'm gonna try to, at the end of the, of the workshop, I'm gonna try to answer if you have any questions or comments or things like that. Because yes, maybe sometimes I'm gonna forget some things, who knows? So as I told you, my name is Veronique, and I have been a professional painter my whole life, I can say that. And I was also a teacher, an art teacher, and a college professor for a number of years. But now I also have my own company, and it's called Atelier Vero. And you can find me online. And if you look on the comments, you're gonna see the links, and you can go have a look at my website, my artworks, and my shop, and all kinds of things like that. So today, this is what we are going to do. And so I thought that for the first workshop that we're going to do together, I thought that it was going to be fun to start with just the basics. So I don't know if some of you already know a lot about acrylic painting and mixing colors and things like that, but I think it's also a good class to do just as a review, because you're going to learn, as I'm telling you, a lot about how to work with acrylic painting, which is kind of different than oil painting or watercolor painting. And also you're going to mix your own colors, because maybe at home right now you have a bunch of different colors, but definitely if you already know me, you know that I'm working a lot just with the three primary colors, and I'm doing my own mix. And also, you can use your own colors. So if you have some greens or some purples or stuff like that, don't worry, you can also use those if you want to. So you see over here that these are some of the artworks that you're gonna be able to do today. And those are examples that I did for you, and I'm only using acrylic paint for all of this. So you can definitely create something like that at the end of the class. Maybe you're not gonna be done at the end of the class, but at least you will know what to do. So after that, it's gonna be pretty easy and straightforward to continue your artwork. And you see that I did those artwork on a large surface. I did paint those on paper. But definitely you can use another surface, or you could decide to do like a bunch of small ones and just position them right next to each other. That would be another really, really fun workshop not workshop, but assignment to do. And you see, so I'm showing you three completely different artwork, always using the same technique, but you're gonna see that all the colors are different. And today you're also gonna make decision. Are you gonna just go with the flow and just apply the colors randomly? Or are you gonna decide, already I wanna use a set of blues, I wanna use these colors, and that is completely fine. You could decide to do that too. So those are the three examples that I did for you today. And those three examples that I showed you, they are using only, again, the primary colors over here. And if you are completely new to painting, and maybe it's the case, maybe you don't even know what I'm talking about when I'm talking about primary colors and what are the primary colors and how to use them and how to mix them. So you see over here, I have some documents over here, and I did that for you. So I'm just absolutely amazing. I did that just only for you. So you see that I have three different documents over here. And if you are not new to painting and you have been painting forever, don't even worry about it, because maybe you're looking at this and you're saying to yourself, oh my gosh, I don't need to know anything about this. But if you do, completely novice, and you don't know anything about mixing colors and what are the primary colors, you can just go on my website, ateliervero.com/workshop. The link is in the chat, and you can download all of these, and already you're going to be able to understand what mixing color is all about. And you see over here, the first document that I did for you over here, you have the three primary colors. And if you mix all the primary colors, it's gonna give you another set of colors. And again, there is another document that I did for you if you wanna experiment with color blending. Again, you can go online, you can go on my website, you can download all of this for free, and you will be able to experiment like crazy, okay? And also I did, you see over here that little drawing that I did, it's all about theory of colors. So again, it's the same thing, and I'm not gonna spend forever doing this, because as I'm telling you, I don't want to spend like 15 hours just talking about mixing colors. I think I should do another video, and it's going to be only on that, because it's pretty basic and I don't want to bother you with this if you already know about this. But just really quickly, you see over here, those are the three primary colors, the red, the yellow, the blue. Maybe you're thinking about, oh my gosh, I remember that when I was in school, in middle school, we were talking about that. Yes, maybe you do. And over here, I did all the mixing combination for you over here. So when you mix the colors, red and blue, you have the purple. The yellow and the red, you have the orange. Blah, 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 blah. I'm not gonna do that forever, you understand. Please go online. You can download everything. You can refresh your color 101 theory that maybe you forgot. Or if you are a painter and you know all there is to know about this, maybe you don't need to do that, but maybe you just want to refresh it. So please go on my website and download everything. And also what I wanted to show you is, and again, maybe it's something that you saw before, maybe you used this before, that color wheel. So the color wheel is a magical tool that you can use to first to mix colors and to see, okay, if I'm trying to mix one color with the other color, what is it going to look like? And also, you see, there is two sides. So it's like, ooh, magic, magic, magic. And on top of it, there is another magic that thing, oh la la, it twists. Okay. So if you're using a color wheel like this, and by the way, you can find a color wheel in art supply store, and I'm sure nowadays there is nothing like the online shopping. So I'm sure you can go online, Amazon, or all those places like Dick Blick, like Jerry Aratarama, and I never know how to pronounce it, but you can go online and you can find all of this online and you can buy it. Yes, it's magic. So you can buy it online. And what is nice with this, that color wheel, you can use it all the time. I know painters that use it every single time they are painting a painting. And you see that when you look, again, I'm not going to spend forever just talking about this, but when you look at this, you see that you have the three primary colors. So over here, you have the red, you have the blue, you have the yellow, and basically it shows you, okay, if I'm mixing the red and the blue, I'm going to have the violet. If I'm mixing the red and the yellow, I'm going to have the orange. If I'm mixing, but I'm not going to continue doing this forever. But what is nice is that, okay, if you turn it like this, you see that all the colors changes in the middle. And it's just because, okay, what if I have the orange, the yellow orange over here, and I'm adding red? It's going to look like this. What if I'm adding blah, 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 blah? Okay. And if you turn on the other side, ooh la la, again, that twisting thing is happening like this. Okay. And you have the same colors here that you have up front over here. But when you turn it over here, you have the shades of the colors, okay? So you see it's the colors, but different tonality, different shades. And in the middle over here, you have the complementary color. So the color that goes super well with the other colors. Again, I'm not spending 3 hours doing this, but they are called complementary. And of course, you have split complementary and triad and tetrad, and you can go on forever, meaning the three colors that goes together, the four colors that goes together. So it would be a good thing if you have lots of interest in this and you want to learn a bit more about color, color theory and all of that, how to mix color. And you could decide, okay, I'm going to paint an artwork right now. And when I'm going to begin painting my artwork, I'm going to say to myself, okay, I know that I want some red. So maybe if I want to have the complementary color of red, it will be green. And so you can play with this forever. And again, go online. You can download all of this for you. And also forgot to tell you, but I did put a list of my favorite art supplies online. So if you want to look online, go help yourself. It's free. It's there. It's for you. Okay. So what I'm going to do next is I'm just going to show you what you're going to need today. So today for the mixing of color assignment, okay, and I'm going to put everything over here and I'm going to show you everything. First thing you will need, as I told you at the beginning, you will need primary colors like this, okay? So you're going to need a yellow, a red, and a blue. If you have other colors, good for you. Also, you're going to need a white and you're going to need a black. This is it. You're only going to need five colors, okay? If you want to talk about, if you want me to talk about brands of colors and all of this, I'm not going to talk about this too much because I just want us to create, but you can go again online and you can look at my supplies list, and I'm telling you the brands that I like the most. This Winsor Newton, I'm not paid for this, by the way. It's just that I really, really like it. And the pigments are great. The density is great. The colors are bold. So good for me. I like them. I'm using them. Okay. You're going to need, that's all you're going to need in terms of paint today. In terms of paint brushes, you see my old beat up paint brushes like this. And usually that's what I'm using. I don't need to have 15,000 paint brushes. Maybe if I'm painting one of my regular painting, maybe I'm gonna have like a smaller, finer one. But if you have those paint brushes, kind of paint brushes that looks like this, you're good to go. If you just have one today, it's gonna work. Don't even worry about it, okay? Some people, sometimes they're asking me, should I have a round tip brush? Should I have a square tip brush? You know what? Me, I like the round better, but I think it's because it goes with my personality. But hey, if you want to have a square brush, please go and work with a square brush, because it's like anything else in life. You need to try it. You need to try it. You need to experiment. You need to say, okay, I like this one better. No, this one. Okay, it's like anything else. The only thing that I'm going to tell you about is, please don't buy paint brushes that are super, super, super cheap, or you're using your kids' paint brushes, because, oh la la, you're going to see that all the bristles are going to come out, and now you're going to have bristles all over your artwork, and it's going to look like crap. Okay, sorry to tell you that, but it's kind of the truth. Okay, so you're going to need paint brushes. On top of it, you're going to need some buckets of water like this. Okay, and you're also going to need, of course, you're going to need rags and all of that. And you're going to need a surface. Okay, and when I'm talking about a surface like this, you have different choices, and you can use any of these and it's going to work perfectly. Okay, meaning you can use a canvas board like this. You know, those canvas board, I use them all the time, and they are great because, geez, you can find them anywhere, and now you can even go at Target and they're having those. So those are perfect. Okay, and they come in all kinds of different sizes. You can also use a pre-stretched canvas. Let's just say you want to go crazy and you're saying, you know what, I'm gonna paint this, and after that, I'm gonna put it in my room. So good for you. So this is a canvas that is stretched over here on a frame already, and you just have to install it on the wall. So you could decide to use something like that. But let's just, for today, let's just go really simple, and I'm just gonna use a piece of mixed media paper like this. So those mixed media papers like this, you can find those. They come in a tablet, and you can find those at all the art supply store. And it says mixed media paper. So you can put it, it can be wet over here, and it's not gonna create like a weird texture because it's wet. Okay, so this is good to go. You could also decide to use a watercolor paper, and it's gonna work, and it's gonna be perfect. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use this piece of paper over here, and the first thing that I'm gonna do, I'm gonna fix it over here on my surface, okay? And I'm gonna use just plain old masking tape like this, because if you don't fix it on the surface over here, when you're gonna begin to paint, your paper is gonna move like that all the time, okay? So you're just gonna take this tape over here And you're just gonna, first thing, you're just gonna fix it on your table like this. So I'm gonna take maybe 4 pieces of masking tape like this. And now it's gonna be fixed on my surface. And now I know that this piece of paper, it's not gonna move around when I'm gonna begin painting like this. Okay, which is great. Okay, the second thing that I'm gonna do, and I forgot to tell you this, you're gonna need to have a pencil like this, or if you don't have a pencil, you could also use paint and it's gonna work. Okay, so don't even worry about this if you don't have a pencil, because at the end it's gonna work if you're just using paint, okay? The first thing that I'm gonna do to create the artwork that I've shown you at the beginning of the class is I'm gonna put some dots over here on my surface, okay? So this step is gonna be to create the composition, okay? So you saw that there is some line, there is some spaces, some different colors, all kinds of things happening. So what I'm gonna do with my pen over here, I'm just gonna put on the surface 12 dots, okay? I'm gonna tell you 12, but it could be 15, it could be 20. So if you wanna experiment a bit later, definitely you can do that. So I'm just gonna put 12 dots over here on the surface. So there's gonna be one over here, one over here, one over here, one over here. And you can do the same thing as me. I'm just placing dots on the surface. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. So what I just did is I'm repeating myself. I just took a pencil. I just draw 12 dots over here on my piece of paper. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And now that I have those 12 dots on the surface, I'm just gonna join all those 12 dots with a line, okay? And it can be a curved line, it can be a straight line. This, you're gonna need to have and to use your imagination and to create your own artwork, because I'm showing to you what to do, but I'm not gonna create the artwork for you. And it's gonna be your own personality and it's gonna be your own artwork. So I'm just gonna join the dots together. And sometimes I'm gonna do a curve. And sometimes I'm just gonna do a straight line. And when you're doing this, definitely you can experiment with all kinds of things. Meaning, you could decide, I'm just gonna do straight lines, I'm just gonna do curves. I'm gonna play with the mix of curves and with the mix of straight lines. So you see what I'm doing by joining the dots. And when I'm joining all the dots together, I'm trying to have a general sense of what my composition is gonna look like. I know that sometimes it's a bit weird also with abstract art to try to figure out, okay, my composition is gonna look like this. I'm going to try this and hopefully it's going to look for the best. But you know what? Just trust yourself. You know, it's like in life. Just trust yourself and trust that everything is going to go fine. And magically, it will. So same for your artwork, you know. Please, I'm hearing you. I'm hearing some of you right now and you're telling yourself, no, I don't think I'm going to be able to do this. I'm not sure if it's going to look good. Blah, 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 blah. Please stop it. Stop it and create. And don't evaluate yourself too much. You're just here to have fun. You're here to experiment. So let's just do that. So you see where I'm going with my artwork and what it's beginning to look like. And you see that sometimes there is an empty space over here that I can say, you know what? There was an empty space over here. I'm just going to close it. Same over here. I'm just going to close it. And after that, I can play forever with that thing, meaning that I can tell myself, okay, now I'm going to take some of these dots like this. And again, I'm again continuing the composition that I'm doing now, meaning that I'm just going to continue playing like this forever and ever. And I'm just going to come up with a composition that, for me, I think that looks good. Okay? So you see that for me, I'm using lots of straight lines. There is a couple curves. But, you know, I could also decide to go crazy with this. And now I'm adding some curves in my composition. So I could also decide to do that. Okay. And you see when you're looking at my composition, again, there is lots of curves. There is some straight lines and all of this. But you can also decide, and it stays in the middle, but you can also decide to go out of the frame like this and continue the composition out of the frame, out of the frame, you know? So this is infinite of what you can do with this. So imagine if you would spend an hour just doing the lines, and after an hour you would say, you know what? Okay, I'm done with just playing with lines. And now I'm going to begin playing with colors. But definitely, you could say, I'm going to play with the lines forever. And after I'm done with this, the forever thing, I'm going to begin playing with the color. Okay, so you could definitely do that. So when I'm looking at my composition like this, sometimes what helps is to close one eye and to look with just the other eye, or to kind of close your eye and look at your composition. And you can also twist it. So I'm not going to do that now, but you could take your paper, just take off all those tapes, and you can just turn it around and say, okay, do I like the way it looks now? Should I add some lines? You can also decide, hey, you have an eraser. So you could say, am I gonna get rid of all those lines? Okay. You know, I told you at the beginning that I was doing this with a pencil, and maybe you don't have it, but you could do the same process over here with a paintbrush and some ink, and just play loosely with the colors like this. Not with the colors, but with the ink, the black ink, and it would still work and it would be perfect. So you could still do that and it would work, okay? The next step that we're gonna do is apply the color. colors. And again, if you want to apply the colors, you have two choices. So you could decide, I'm just going to go with the flow. I'm going to do some mix of colors. And after that, I'm going to apply it to my artwork. But also, la la la, you could say, I'm going to use my color wheel. And already, I know that this artwork is going to have some red, some blue, some purple. Let's just say that, okay? You could decide to do that too. That's why I showed you about the color wheel over here. So you see over here that I have my three primary colors that I showed you at the beginning of the class, okay? And I have a black and I have a white, okay? At first, I'm just gonna use my three primary colors. And I do have a piece of paper over here that I'm just gonna put on the side. So you're gonna be able to see all the mixing of colors that I'm doing. So I'm just putting this piece of paper on the side and on my piece of paper, and I'm using a piece of mixed media paper, but definitely you could use an old plate, a takeout container or something like that to put your paint on, and it's gonna work. So please don't do as I do it, and don't put the paint on the table. I did put the paper over here, but you can use, as I told you earlier, or you know, sometimes they are selling those, and I hate those, I really do. You know, they are selling those little containers that you can put just a tiny amount of paint, and right next to it, you put another tiny amount, and right next to it, you need to put a tiny amount. Oh my gosh, I hate those. I hate those because for me, I don't think that you can do anything with those. Okay, so I have over here my three primary colors, which are Color Theory 101, which are the red, the blue, the yellow. And I'm also gonna put, I'm not even gonna play with the black right now, because usually when you're adding black to the colors, it, oh my gosh, I was gonna say it in French, but means ça éteint la couleur. It means it darkens the color, okay? So you don't wanna go too crazy with the black, adding black to the colors, okay? But we're gonna use it at the end. And I'm just gonna put a tiny bit of white over here so I can use a bit of white, because maybe I'm not gonna use a lot of white, but I'm sure when I'm gonna begin applying color on my artwork, I'm sure that at one point I'm gonna use some white to create some kinds of pastels, you know, colors that are paler. And I'm pretty sure that it would be really, really, really fun to use. So let's just do that. So I have all of my colors over here. I have some water over here. I have all my colors, and I need a rag, and I forgot. Ooh, I have one over here. So you're gonna need a rag too. And lots of times people are asking me, students are asking me, how do you blend the colors, and do you use too much water, not enough water, is there going to be lots of water? I think that you should look at what I'm doing right now, and it's going to come up to you. Again, it's another thing that you need to do it to know what you like the best, and how you want to use the paint with lots of water and it looks like a wash or a watercolor effect, or you really want to use the paint and it's going to be almost 100% paint. But definitely you do need to experiment and try different things, okay? So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to put some water on my paintbrush over here. And at first, I'm just going to play with the primary colors, okay? So I'm just going to begin with the yellow like this, and randomly I'm just going to fill up some part of my artwork like this. So I'm just going to randomly select. I know that some of you might say, well, she's not doing the black lines at first. I said, not doing the black lines at first. I'm just beginning with the colors. I'm just going to play with colors right now. So at first, I'm just going to work with the primary colors. And randomly, I'm going to work with those primary colors over here. And just again, as I told you at the beginning, just trust yourself and just look at your abstract art right now and just tell yourself, okay, maybe I think it would be good if there was a bit of yellow over here. And maybe I could leave those empty spaces and experiment with other colors later, okay? So you see that I didn't reapply tons of water just doing one color. Now I'm gonna rinse my paintbrush over here. And I'm just gonna dab it with my rag over here. So my brush is still wet, but it's not crazy wet. And after that, I'm still gonna go on with another primary color. And the one that I'm gonna use is the red right now. So now I'm gonna do exactly the same thing. And now you kind of understand where am I going with this. And what is really fun and nice with this artwork, this abstract artwork, is that the possibilities are infinite. Meaning that you could do this artwork on a really, 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 really large surface. You can do it. You remember what I told you at the beginning of the class? You can do it in multiple small ones, small art surface, lots of small canvas board, lots of small piece of paper, and all these artworks would go side by side. Or you could do a mural like this, and I'm sure it would look pretty amazing. I'm sure about that. So you see how I'm building my artwork right now, and all the different colors that are going together. And again, when I'm doing this, so you see that I did all the yellow colors, color spacing. Now I'm doing all the red colors. I like to do that. I like to do, okay, you know what? I'm just gonna do all the same color together. And I always love, I told you that earlier, I always love, I'm closing one eye and I'm looking at it. And I'm like, okay, so maybe if I would add a tiny bit more red over here, it would be good. Okay. So I think that I'm done with the red right now. And again, I'm doing the same thing. So rinsing my paintbrush over here. And no, you don't need to change your water all the time. Don't worry about it. And again, I'm just going to dab the excess water over here. And now I'm going to use my third primary color, which is the blue. Okay. And I'm still going to do the same thing. So now I just have the blue. And another thing. Maybe you're going to tell me, well, my blue doesn't look the same as your blue. Well, you know what? Good for you. it means that it's not gonna look like me. So, and I like that because this is perfect. Okay. So yes, maybe you're gonna buy one brand of acrylic paint and your blue is gonna be darker, but it's still gonna look amazing. I'm sure about that. So if you want exactly the same colors that I have right now, you could, but I think that you should go crazy and have your own colors. I think so. I really do. And I'm sure your artwork is gonna be pretty amazing to me. Okay, so now I'm just playing. So you see, you could definitely decide and you could say, you know what, I'm gonna do this artwork only with the primary colors. You could do that, you know, if you want to. Definitely, that's something that could happen. So I'm just playing over here with the blue. That blue looks nice. I like it. It's like an electric blue. Okay, and I think I'm gonna put another one over here. So I'm putting the colors really randomly. And that's the way to go. You know, you just need to trust your instinct and say, you know what? I think that would be nice if it was there and if something was happening there and blah, blah, blah. Okay, so now I just played with the primary colors. And what I'm going to do next is, oh la la, I'm going to mix my own colors. Woo! Okay, so I'm always, you see that I'm always doing the same. I'm always rinsing my paintbrush when I'm done with the color, and after that I'm dabbing it with my fantastic rag. And now I'm gonna mix colors. So let's just say that I'm gonna begin by mixing the primary colors, and I'm gonna mix now the yellow with the blue. And you must remember your middle school or something, or maybe some of you did the art department, college, high school, blah, blah, blah. And you see over here that I'm creating a green just by mixing the yellow and the blue. And your green is maybe paler than mine, and maybe you don't even, you're not even gonna use green. So you see that when you think about it, you don't really need to buy any other paint. I know that you're gonna tell me, well, it's kind of nice to have a green and I don't need to mix it all the time, and it can be exactly the green that I want, and it can be same with all the color, the orange, the purple, blah, blah, blah. But it's also really fun, and I always like to do that, to just mix my own colors, because sometimes it brings you to places that you would have never expected. Never, never, never. I'm playing with the green right now. It's almost like a road trip. You know, you're going on a road trip and you don't know what you're gonna go, and you arrive somewhere and you tell yourself, oh my God, I would have never thought that I was gonna arrive there. And now, fantastic things happen. Yeah. Okay. So I'm playing with the green. And I played with the blue. I played with the yellow. I played with the red. And I think I'm not going to put too much green, because I'm looking at it right now. And I was tempted to go all green at the bottom over here, but I think I'm gonna refrain myself, and worst case, you know what? I can come back later and add some more. So, okay. Now, let's just play with orange. I think this is gonna be a good one. So I'm mixing again, color mixing one and one, just mixing the red with the yellow. And oh my gosh, my red is really deep, so. Let's just see how that orange is gonna look like. Yeah, that's a deep, bold orange, because my red color is really, really bold. So if I wanted to have something paler than this, I could add more yellow because it kind of looked the same. It's almost the same. I think I should add more yellow. So I'm gonna add more yellow to my orange over here. And now it's gonna become, you see how much I'm adding right now. So my orange now should be really, really, really pale. Let's just look at that. Let's see how it goes. Okay, so now, oh yes, now it's gonna look nice. So now I'm adding lots and lots of yellow to my orange, and I'm just gonna go on top of it, but the orange that I used at the beginning, it was so deep that, oh la la. Okay, this one is definitely better. So it's almost, this assignment, this class of today, it's almost like a meditation. You know, you're doing it. Me, I'm talking all the time to entertain you, but definitely you could do that artwork and just relax and unwind, listen to nice music. You can even do this artwork with your friends and, oh, I'm gonna put two orange side by side then. Now it's gonna become like a big bold orange like this. I think I'm gonna put a tiny bit more orange than everything else and see how it goes. Yeah, because I really love that orange. It has a nice, really nice pop of color. Yeah, so this assignment, what is great with it is that you don't need to overthink it. No, it's like taking a walk in the forest, you know, you just enjoy, like, oh yeah, it's a, yeah. You know what I mean? I'm sure you do. You out there. So I'm playing with the orange right now, and you see how I am building my artwork square after square, shapes after shapes, and looking at it, stopping it, looking at it. What is always good is you could stop right now, just put your paint in a container so it's still gonna stay wet, and you could come back a bit later and just look at it and say, okay, you know what, I'm just gonna stop, I'm gonna wait, I'm gonna see what's happening, if some, you know, when I'm gonna come back in an hour, what is it gonna look like, blah, blah, blah. You could definitely decide to do that, okay? So I'm just gonna continue with my third mix of colors, and my third mix of colors is by mixing the red and the blue over here. And by mixing that red and that blue, I'm gonna have like a purple color. And as I told you at the beginning, when I began mixing the colors, you see over here how dark it is, but it's because my red and my dark are so deep that now it would be fun to add a tiny bit of white like this. And now it can become like a lavender color. Okay, so you see when I was talking about the pastels, that's what I was talking about. And now I'm just gonna continue using my colors that I mixed myself. And now I'm coming in with the purple, and now my purple looks a bit like a lavender color because I just added a tiny bit of white. And I'm just gonna fill up some of the spaces. And you could say to yourself, you know what? I'm just gonna use five colors. I'm just gonna use three colors. I'm just gonna use 1,000 colors. You could go crazy with this. And Again, I told you at the beginning, and I think it's a really, really fun and good exercise to do when you're just beginning painting like this, because you don't really know how to use your paintbrush, how to use the paint, how to mix the paint, how to mix the paint with the water and see, okay, do I like it when it's really, really liquidy? Do I like it when it's really, really dense and I have lots of paint on my paintbrush? You can experiment with all of those different techniques over here. So you see where my artwork is going right now, and I don't want to go too crazy with other colors. For me, in my head, I'm just thinking about my head. For me, I think that I already have lots and lots and lots of colors right now. For me, for my artwork, okay? Maybe yours is completely different and you want to go crazy and you want to experiment with a bunch of different colors. But for me, I think that it would be nice just to stay in the same color scheme. So I would love to just look at my artwork and see, okay, you know what? I'm just gonna keep experimenting with this over here and see how it goes from there, okay? And when I'm looking at my artwork right now, I can see that lots of colors are about the same, okay? So I'm looking at my artwork, lots of colors are about the same. And now, what am I gonna decide to do with all of this, okay? So am I gonna continue just using the same colors? Am I gonna create other colors? I could also decide to paint on top of other colors. You know, I could say, you know what? I don't like this green, I don't like this red, I'm gonna paint on top of it. You could also decide to do that. And it would work, definitely it would work, okay? So, what you can do right now is look at your artwork and make some decisions, okay? You take some decision, you decide what you wanna do, and you go from there. So me, I really love what is happening with the blue, okay? I think the blue looks really, really, really good. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm just gonna continue playing with the blue and see how it goes from there, okay? So I'm taking again my paintbrush like this, okay? And I'm just gonna continue filling up the space with my blue color over here, okay? So I'm just continuing the process that I'm doing right now. So right now, you heard me. I made a decision. I said, okay, I'm looking at all my empty space and I don't think I have enough blue. So I'm just gonna go on and continue painting with the blue color because I think if there is more blue, it's gonna look great. And I also think that I should have a blue that is paler. I'm just gonna fill up lots of those spaces, those empty spaces. And yes, I know that you have that question. You can leave some white space too. Definitely, you could do that. So I'm just gonna fill up some of the spaces with the blue. like this. And again, I'm always doing that. I'm closing my eyes. I'm looking at it. Should I add this? Should I, okay, what should I do? Blah, blah, blah. And you remember at the beginning, I told you that you also have the contour of the surface, meaning that you could say, you know what? I have all of this contour over here. And I'm just gonna put some colors over here. So I have the main artwork over here, all the lines that I draw before, but also I could decide to paint the contours like this to add dimensions and depths and all of that. I'm looking again at my artwork, and now I think I'm gonna play, but with different blues. So I still have that blue over here, but I'm gonna add a tiny bit of white, like this, okay? And now I'm gonna use the same blue, but you see that it's a bit paler, almost like a pale, pastel blue. Like that. And again, I'm just playing with the pale blue. Okay, so now you see where I'm going, how it's going. I just have the pale blue like this. Like that. And I think it looks good. And I'm just filling up the spaces with the pale blue. And you see that I'm just using one paintbrush, my big paintbrush, same paintbrush from the beginning, but you could also say, I'm gonna use completely different paintbrush because I want to go in those small, really small places and all of that. But hey, if you want to do that, good for you. But you don't have to. Definitely, you don't. You can use the same paintbrush everywhere and it's going to work. Don't even worry about it. So you see that now I'm playing with my pale blue. I didn't add lots of different colors. And I think I'm just going to do same thing as I did. I'm just going to do the contour over here with, yeah, I'm just going to do, oh my gosh, it looks good, like that. I wish I could see yours, but I'm sure it looks amazing. And don't hesitate to send it to me if you want some reviews or if you want me to have a look at it. And so now you see that I'm just painting the contour like this, like that. Nice, nice. Okay. And I'm just gonna also continue playing just a tiny bit over here. I think a bit more yellow would look nice. I think so. I have a feeling that it would look nice. Maybe a pale orangey yellow. Yeah, like this one over here. Yeah, it's almost like it's a really, 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 let me take some of that. Yeah, a bit, oh yeah. It's like a light orange like this. Ooh. Look at that. Perfect. So you see that how I'm building my artwork like that? I don't question myself too much. I'm just looking at the colors, experimenting with the mixing of colors, taking a step back, looking at my artwork and telling myself, okay, this looks good. Okay, nah, well, maybe I should put more blue. Maybe I should put more orange. And you can experiment with this artwork forever and ever and ever. Is this a song? Forever and ever. Na, na, na. Okay, like that. I think it looks pretty good. That's pretty good. Yeah, woohoo! Yeah, so now you're looking at this and maybe you're telling yourself, oh boy, it doesn't look like anything that she showed us at the beginning, okay? And of course it doesn't, because I didn't put any black lines in all of this, okay? And now you're gonna put some black lines, okay? And maybe now you're looking at your artwork and maybe you're gonna say, I'm not sure about the colors. Maybe I should have done something different, but that's completely fine. You know why? Because this is your first one. So after that, you could decide, okay, you know, I just painted one practice, working with the colors, but now maybe this weekend, maybe in 2 or 3 days, I'm gonna do another one and I'm gonna try to experiment with the shapes, with the colors. Maybe you're gonna use the color wheels and all of that, and now you're gonna have other possibilities. And isn't that funny? I just saw that I had a big line like this. It's like the horizon. Can you believe it? I didn't even think about that. Okay, so things happen. So this is your artwork and what it should look right now. And at this point, you can still look at it and you can tell yourself, do I like the colors? Should I change the colors? And you can still do that because, as I told you, you could decide to paint over it. But a good thing to do is always to stop. To stop, to go eat, take a walk, go have a chat with your friend, name it. And after that, you're going to come back. You're going to look at it. And maybe you're going to say, this and that I could have done different. This and that, I don't like this. Or maybe you're going to come back and you're going to say, you know what? I just adore it. I think it looks pretty awesome. Okay? So now what you're going to do, you're going to use some black paint. And you can use black paint. And when I'm telling you about the black paint is to do all those black lines that are surrounding all the shapes. You don't need to use black. You could definitely use another color like brown, a deep brown, a deep purple, you know, go crazy. You can go crazy if you want to. But I'm just going to put, for me, I'm just going to put a tiny bit of black over here. And I'm going to mix it with a tiny bit of red color. First, why? Because I have tons of red color. And on top of it, I'm just going to wet my paintbrush. And I'm going to use a paintbrush that is a bit tinier. You don't need to do that, but definitely, if you have a paintbrush that is a bit tinier, maybe, I'm telling maybe because I don't see your paintbrush right now. Maybe it's going to glide a bit better on the surface, okay? So I have a black that had a tiny bit of red, a tiny bit of red color, okay? So it's like a brownish hue, okay? And what I'm going to do now, and I'm going to take up some of that paint over here, but what I'm going to do now is, you remember the lines that you did at the beginning? So I'm just going to go on top of all those lines like this. And now I'm going to continue working on my artwork like this. And please don't worry too much about the quality of your black line. Seriously, it doesn't really matter if the line is too thick or too thin, or just experiment with it. And sometimes you won't have any paint left on your paintbrush because you're gonna glide the paintbrush over like this, and it's perfectly fine. So you see what I'm doing right now? I'm just, all the lines that we did at the beginning of the class with the pencil, I'm just going on top of them like that. Oh, my horizon line over here. Horizon, I should say. Horizon. Like that. And I'm just continuing playing. And sometimes, yes, you can add a tiny bit of water. And this way, it's going to glide a bit more easily. And you're just continuing your creation, your artwork like this, by playing. Now you played with the forms, with the colors, and now you are playing with the lines. Okay, maybe you are thinking that I have a really, really steady hand, and it's true, but I've been doing this for a long time. So that's why I have a steady hand. Practice makes perfect. Woo! I'm continuing just joining all the lines together. And you don't need to put lines everywhere. You know, I could look at my artwork right now and see, you know what? I think it looks pretty great like this, so I'm going to leave it like that. You could decide then. But me, I'm just going to continue playing with it. And again, you're kind of in a meditation state. I like doing this kind of artwork. It's really nice. It's really fun. You unwind after a stressful week or a stressful day. You're just having fun with the colors and the paint. What can be better than that? Nothing! Well, yeah, no. Well, maybe a couple of things. Okay, so what does it look like? Woo! Looks pretty good. Yeah. And when you're looking at your artwork, I'm sure it's way better than what you think it is. I'm sure about that. Don't. Please don't. I'm just gonna say that. Please don't. Okay, so you see where it's going. I think it's going pretty well. Maybe I'm just gonna continue over here outside the surface. And maybe I should add like a couple lines like that. Yeah. And maybe over here something needs to happen. See how it goes from there. Yeah, like that. Yeah, I don't want to put too much lines because I kind of like you know, some things that are happening in the artwork. You know, over here, there is no line in the middle. Same over here. And I kind of like the look that what the artwork looks like right now. So I think I'm just going to leave it this way. And, you know, you could decide all the lines that you see right now, they look kind of the same, you know, same width. But you could decide to, maybe some lines are going to be thicker. And they're going to have a completely different width than the other ones. So you can play with the lines, and sometimes they're going to be thicker, and sometimes they're going to be lighter. Let's just say that. Not as thick, I'm going to say that. Not as thick. Okay. Oh yes, I'm going to do that. And you're just continuing to play with all those lines, okay? And this, again, you can play with this forever, okay? Meaning that all those lines can be reworked individually, okay? Meaning that I can look at every single space. You know what I'm doing right now? When, if you're looking at how am I painting this artwork, is you see that I'm just taking every single space. You know, like this small space over here, this small space over here. And now I'm just playing with the black lines, and I'm looking at the space and say, oh, you know, that would be nice if the space was a rounder shape. You see what I'm doing? And again, you can decide to play with all the shapes separately. And when you play with all the shapes separately, it's visually appealing. Now other things are happening. You know, you have rounder shapes because you reworked those black lines. And I can do that for every single shapes. You see what I'm doing? Or I could decide to do it with just a couple shapes and say, okay, you know what? This shape, this shape, this shape. I'm going to rework those. I'm going to leave those like this. So basically the artwork at the beginning is very simple. Schematize. It's only shapes. Mixing of color, black line. But once you are done with all of this, meaning the mixing of colors, the black lines, applying the colors, now you can have fun and fun and fun and fun forever and ever, because you can decide to play with every single shape. So what if I was taking my artwork? I'm going to go crazy here. And I'm going to turn it. Ooh, la, 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 la. Ooh, la, 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 la. Oh, my rag just fell on the floor. I'm going to. Ooh, la, 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 la. What am I doing? And ooh. So now you see, I just turned it for fun. Just did that for fun. I'm just going to grab my rag because I'm going to use it. And now I see my artwork, and this is always a good thing to do. Always, 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 always. To turn around your artwork and to look at it in a different point of view. Okay. And oh my gosh, I like this artwork. I think it looks good. And I'm just gonna, now I turn my artwork and I'm just gonna continue working with the shapes and with the lines. And closing my eyes a tiny bit and looking at my artwork and say, you know what? Okay, maybe I can do this, maybe I can do that. And I'm again, just playing with the shapes, looking at the colors, looking at my black lines. Yeah, doesn't look too bad. I think it looks good. I like it. Like it. So I'm just gonna step down a tiny bit and I'm gonna look at my artwork like this. And just see, should I add something? Should I do something different? I kind of like it right now. I kind of like what it's looking like. And I'm just wondering, what should I do next? And because for me right now, I think it looks pretty good. Maybe I'm gonna add a tiny bit more colors than this, but not colors, but maybe a tiny bit more lines than this. But I think for me, it looks pretty good right now. So I'm just gonna, again, I'm just gonna re-explain everything that I did really quickly. So right now, what I did at the beginning, I just painted the shapes, different shapes of colors, and played with the colors side by side. Sometimes I mixed the colors. Sometimes it was just mixing the two primary colors together. You remember, I did mix all the colors over here prior. And after that, I just apply all the colors together. And after that, I just decided to paint all the black lines one after another. And maybe my black doesn't look as quite as your black, because you remember that I did add some red over here to my black, because it adds a bit of depth over here when you add a tiny bit of black. So I'm just continuing like this. I'm just playing with my lines like this. Okay, and again, as I told you earlier, you could do an artwork like this forever. It's like a meditation. So you're meditating and painting. We need that nowadays. Definitely. We need that nowadays. Tranquility, meditation, relaxing, breathing. We need that. Okay, so I'm just doing, you see all the black lines that I did. And now I'm just playing with the shapes, basically. I'm just looking at my artwork, and it's always good to look at your artwork, but all together, and to tell yourself, okay, so maybe I should do this, maybe I should do that, maybe I can change this, maybe I can change that. And even if you are here, you know, sometimes you're doing an artwork and you're telling yourself, oh my God, I don't like it. I think it's awful, which it's never awful. Please stop it. Okay. It's never, it cannot be. But you can still look at your artwork right now and decide, you know what? I don't like this color. I'm going to change it. And you can paint on top of it. It's not because it looks like that, that you cannot do anything, you know? You can definitely change the colors, change the composition. No worries. And please, yes, you can throw it away and experiment and try a new one or repaint on top of it. Seriously, I'm doing that all the time. So please stop it. Okay. So now I'm pretty happy with the final look of it. Usually, you know, when I'm almost done painting a piece of artwork like this, I'm repeating myself, I told you that earlier, I'm just closing my eyes a tiny bit, looking at it, telling myself, should I do something different? Should I do this? Should I do that? But I kind of like what's going on over here. You know, it's an abstract art, but you know, it's kind of like with the bold colors and all of that, and the shapes. It feels organic to me, and I kind of really, really like it. So I think I'm gonna leave it this way. And sometimes maybe you're going to look at your artwork and you're going to say, oh yeah, but if I'm looking at just this part over here, I don't like it. Please don't do that. Just don't look at the small part of your artwork. Just look at the whole thing all together. Okay. Not just a tiny piece like that, that says, oh my gosh, it's just, I don't like it. It looks awful. No, it doesn't. So please stop. Okay, so I kind of like what's going on over here, and I think I'm going to keep it this way. I love the colors, love what's happening with all the black lines, love the vibe, good energy that is coming through all of this. So I think I'm going to leave it this way, but if you want to continue, seriously, you could continue forever doing, I'm just going to put my paintbrush in the water over here, but you could continue painting this artwork for a long, long time. As I told you at the beginning, you could decide, okay, now that I painted all the shapes, all the lines, played with the colors, played with all the shapes individually, hey, you can go on forever doing this. The sky is the limit. That's what I'm telling you. And also, as I told you at the beginning of the class, you could tell yourself, you know what? It's just one. I just did one. This was the one. Now I'm going to do like 15 like this. Well, maybe not 15 because I'm sure you're going to go crazy, but maybe you can do like 5. Okay, let's just say like this weekend. I'm always telling that to my students, and I think it's a good exercise. Just don't do one and say, oh, you know what? I did one. It was just awful. No, it's not. First, it's not awful. I'm sure about that. Second, imagine the possibilities of doing 15 like this. And you don't have to do this kind of artwork as big as I did it right now. You remember at the beginning of the class, I told you, you could use really, 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 really small canvas board like this and do a bunch of those. And that would be just absolutely awesome, okay? And once you are done with your absolutely fantastic artwork, abstract art. Now you can also decide to frame it, okay? And I'm just gonna show it to you. I'm just gonna put all my things on the side over here, okay? And I'll repeat everything that I said at the beginning. Don't worry if you have some questions at the end. And I know that some of you said, oh my gosh, it looks great. Thank you, you are the best. but you remember the examples that I showed you at the beginning? So this is exactly the same technique, exactly the same, okay? Exactly the same technique, okay? The same, okay? Just different colors, combination. You remember using that color wheel, using that mixing of colors that we saw at the beginning of the class. Again, do not hesitate to go on my website and to download all of those things over here for free. Woo! Everything is free. You go on my website, ateliervero.com/, I love that slash workshops. And you can download everything and also Magic of the Color Wheel. So the color wheel people are not paying me to show you all of this. I'm just doing that because I love you guys and I'm sure you're creating amazing things. The last thing that I want to show you before I answer a couple questions and I'm talking to you a bit more about what we're going to do in the next class. You see, you know, sometimes you buy a frame and they put like a thing like this. I don't, oh gosh, I don't even know what's the name of that thing in English, but I'm going to say it in French and it's called a passe-partout, okay? Is it a mat? I think it's a mat. Okay, so if all of you that are watching me right now, I think it's a mat. I'm going to say a mat. And sometimes, you know, you buy a frame and they put that thing over here in the package, and you know what, I'm always keeping those because those are absolutely awesome. You know why? Already you can see that when I'm using the mat like this and I'm putting it on top of my artwork, oh la la, magic happens again. Magic happens. And look at all the different artworks that are happening and are appearing in the frame like this. Isn't that just absolutely fantastic? I love that. I think it looks better. I think it looks better when I'm putting like a mat like this on top of it and I'm like, oh my gosh, look at that. It looks great. It's like, it's like, you know, when you're creating an artwork and you frame it on your iPhone and you post it online, I think it always looks better than the real thing. Isn't that weird? I think it's because it's smaller. Well, I was just sharing my thought. But so please use those mats over here. And I think that you can also buy those at an art supply store and because they are useful when you create an artwork and you wanna just, oh my gosh, yes, I wanna, oh yeah, and I can do this and I can do that. And so, and tons of possibilities happen. So please go buy one like this, or, and after that you can play. And also you can do one with just pieces of paper and it works and it's perfect. And it does the job, as I said, as I'm saying to you. So I'm just gonna keep a bit of time because that was it for the class today. If you have any questions about things that didn't work for you today, Meaning, oh my gosh, okay, I didn't know how to mix the colors. How can you do this and how can you do that? Please just send me. I see that you are a bunch of people, but I don't have any questions. But please do. I'm going to talk and I'm going to look at all the chats right now. So if you have any question, please do. Or just a comment or want to say hello to everybody, please do. Next week, so today was surprisingly my first live class, broadcast, a stream. Can't say that. And I really enjoyed it. I hope you did. And this, if you want to look at the full class, it's almost an hour and a half. So if you want to look at the full class, the full assignment, you just need to go on my Facebook, Atelier Vero, still the same. I think for the Instagram people, I think the link is on my Instagram profile, and on top of it, I'm gonna put it on my website too. And yes, dear people, it's all free. I just wanna share all of my knowledge with you guys. And so please don't hesitate to write to me or to ask me a bunch of questions or if you have suggestions, blah, blah, blah. But it's gonna be something that I'm gonna repeat every couple of weeks, at least once a month. Sometimes I'm gonna be busier than other times because I have a business and I have lots of work. But so sometimes I'm gonna have time to share, and I'm gonna try to share as much as I can. And I think we're gonna have tons of fun. Next month, what I was gonna share with you in terms of workshop, I should have brought some examples, but I don't have any. That's so me. But it's creating like a portrait. It's kind of using this technique over here with the shapes and the colors and the lines, but doing a portrait that looks really funky, modern, with the expression of the face that are really, really, really interesting. So if you go on my website or you look at my Instagram once in a while, you're going to see that popping up in my stories or on my main Instagram or my newsletter. So you have all the latest news. And yes, you can join in. I'm going to be there. And it's so nice to see you all. So that was it for today. I don't think that nobody... Thank you for all the nice comments. I don't think that nobody has any questions, but thank you for being there. And I'm going to see you next month at least. And I think that I'm probably going to do another workshop class next week to work with pens, like painting pens. I think it would be nice to do like a small assignment with those. So I'm gonna come back to you. Please go to my website, ateliervero.com. Look at my profile. You're gonna have the address, and you can also go on my YouTube, and you can look at all my painting videos. And also, don't hesitate to go on my website, ateliervero.com/workshops. And you can this way download all the free things that you wanna look at. So I have tons of documentation about color mixing and how to mix your color when you're just using the primary colors. So please, 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 you can look at all of this online if you go on my website. And it was nice to see you all, guys. And my name is Vero. And I wish you like an awesome, beautiful week. Oh, I do have a question that just popped up. You know, you are leaving nice, lots of comments. I love your magical terms. Somebody said, I don't understand why my colors are not popping up as much. Somebody said, Vero, I think yours is looking absolutely the best. So, well, thank you, but it's because I'm not seeing yours, so probably that's why. And somebody, Nikki, just asked me a question. Vero, one question. My paint seems to always be too wet or too dry. How wet should the brush be? So you saw that when I was painting on the surface, when I was painting, somebody said, it's Nikki again. Thank you so much for doing this. Really appreciate it. So fun painting with you. Well, it's fun to paint with you. I wish I could see you all, guys, but I know that you're there. So about the painting and the wetting of the paint, there is lots of question of preference when you're doing this, because sometimes you can have a look that it's going to be looking almost like a watercolor, but sometimes it can almost be like a dry paint. And I'm just gonna go, I'm just gonna repaint on top of my artwork over here, and hopefully you're gonna see what I'm doing. First, my paintbrush was in the water like this, okay? So my paintbrush is kind of wet, and I'm just gonna dab it on a little bit on a rack like this. So it's still wet. You see that it's still pretty wet. And when I'm going to apply the paint over here, okay, you see that my brush was wet. And now my paint is on the paintbrush like this, okay? And I'm just going to apply it on the surface. And now there is so much water on my paintbrush that it's almost becoming transparent. So that's what I was gonna tell you, Nikki. I thought you should just take a piece of paper and you should just experiment with painting with lots of water, just using a dry brush. Meaning a dry brush, I mean your paintbrush is completely dry and you're just using the completely dry paint to paint on top of your paintbrush. So you should do some experiment with all of that, because I know that some artists, they really love to work with lots of water in their paint. Some artists, they just want to work with almost a dry effect, a dry paintbrush. So you just need to decide what you're going to like the best and what is going to be the best for you, because there is no amount of water that I can tell you, okay, you need to put like half a cup of water in 3/4 cup of paint. Well, there is no such thing as that. You just need to experiment and try all kinds of different things. So it was nice, all of you, to see you. Thank you for being so... how can I say that? There are so many people out there. I cannot believe it. That was my first live, first painting live. I hope that you liked it. As I told you, I'm going to have a new painting live session every single month. So just go online on Facebook, not Facebook, on YouTube, on Instagram, go on my website, Atelier Vero, just click on the profile. Sometimes it's going to be live on Instagram. Sometimes it's going to be live on YouTube. So just check it out. Every month it's going to be an hour and a half. And an hour and a half, the new assignment every month, playing with colors, playing with shades. I'm sending you the best. And I hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.